Hello friends, I have created this video on how to clear DNB orthopedics tips and tricks, mainly emphasizing on theory and practical exams. This video series is divided into 5 main parts. Part 1, I'll be only concentrating on theory exams excluding the paper 4. The paper 4, which is on recent advances, will be dealt separately in part 2. Part 3 will contain very important tips for the exam day and all the practical exams, books to be read for the practicals and other practical aspects will be discussed extensively in part 4 and part 5. So we'll start our part 1, how to prepare for theory exams. If you got an exam coming up, I think you will find this post in particular to be very helpful. And after you have read it, I would highly recommend you to kindly share with your fellow colleagues who are also preparing for the exams. DNB results are improving year by year, and hence a decent preparation should always fetch you a very good results. The final DNB theory examination will have a total of 4 papers, and each paper will contain 10 short structured questions, which are again classified under 2 sections, Part A and Part B. So what are these short structured questions? If you go through papers before 2010, mostly the questions were direct one-liners like Shorman disease or renal osteodystrophy. But the trend totally changed after 2010, wherein each question is again divided into multiple parts with separate allotment of marks. This is advantageous in terms of scoring marks as well as time management. As per the DNB orthopedic curriculum by NBE, paper 1 will contain basic sciences related to orthopedics, paper 2 will contain principles and practices of orthopedics, paper 3 will contain general surgical principles and allied specialties, and recent advances will be in paper 4. However, this doesn't give you a proper idea in terms of exam preparation. Hence, I reviewed last 5 years of theory papers and classified all topics under 4 papers. So, paper 1 contains basic sciences, metabolic bone disorders and sports medicine. Paper 2 will contain spine, non-traumatic disorders, pediatric orthopedics, arthritis, tumors and infections. Paper 3 will contain foot and ankle, hand, trauma and arthroplasty. And lastly, paper 4 will contain recent advances, biostatistics, research methodology, ethics, legal aspects, health policies and rehabilitation. Again, as per the DNB curriculum, there are set of books which are recommended by National Board of Examinations. And the books recommended for paper 1 are Aplis, Turex, Adams, Mercer's and Campbell's Operative Orthopedics. But from my experience, I would suggest a few books especially for paper 1. Miller's Review of Orthopedics and the initial chapters from Campbell's Operative Orthopedics. And paper 2, where our major questions are from pediatric orthopedics and spine, the books recommended are Pediatric Orthopedics by Tajian, Jaffe's Tumors and Tumorous Conditions, Campbell's Operative Orthopedics and Tuberculosis by S.M. Tully. And my suggestions, especially for part 2, is the infections, spine and tumors I read from Campbell, and pediatric orthopedics, the initial part, especially the pathogenesis, diagnosis, classifications, I read from Tajian, and management is very well given in Benjamin Joseph. And paper 3, where a majority are trauma and arthroplasty questions, the books recommended are Watson and Jones, Rockwood, both adults and children, Sir Charnley's Close Treatment of Fractures, and again Campbell's. And the suggestions from me, number 1, especially for foot, ankle, hand and arthroplasty, it is always Campbell. And trauma, the initial part, the classification, diagnosis, clinical features, I read from Kenneth and Cowell. And management is always from Rockwood. You can also refer Greens for hand. And part 4 or paper 4, where recent advances, health policies and research methodologies are considered, the books recommended are Campbell's Operative Orthopedics, Mohit Bhandari's Evidence-Based Medicine, Stewart's Traction and Sprintage, and Howard and Rusk Rehabilitative Medicine. Coming to the most important part, how to prepare in last 6 to 8 months. Here, you need to prioritize things, and the first priority should always be given for previous year's question papers, preferably last 10 years. Secondly, all the PPTs and class notes which you have collected over last 3 years. And finally, collect topics from last 2 years of IGO. Now, I'll tell you how to prepare from Indian Journal of Orthopedics. Here, I am not discussing how to prepare for paper 4, which is on recent advances. Instead, I'll tell how to prepare for paper 1, 2 and 3. Here, you need to go through the table of contents from IGO, as shown in this picture, and then derive questions from the table of contents, which are potential 5 mark questions. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe for remaining part of the videos.